The carnage of an alleged U.S. drone strike in Pakistan, hated by the bystanders who lose loved ones in such attacks, prized by U.S. military leaders for their increasing effectiveness in eradicating security threats. While the U.S. is normally reluctant to discuss drone strikes, Defense Secretary Leon Panetta defended them this week.
The operations that we've conducted there have been very effective at undermining al-Qaeda and their ability to plan those kinds of attacks.
Hundreds of defense contractors recently came to Washington to show off the latest in unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAV, technology, drones that operate in the water, in the air, and on land.
There is great international interest in equipment and technology that can find, track, and take out military threats. At least 40 countries around the world want this sort of technology in their arsenals, and the companies in this convention hall are here to help.
But critics say for the U.S., the number of civilian casualties, while getting smaller, could foment more anti-American sentiment in places such as Pakistan, Yemen, and Somalia, places where the U.S. is thought to launch the most strikes. But that's not diminishing the popularity of these drones.
The constituency is for drones. There's not really a constituency that's for weighing, again, the costs of drone operations in these foreign countries.
From 2004 to 2008, the U.S. launched just 42 drone strikes against targets in Pakistan. But in 2009, when President Barack Obama took office, the number soared to 53 in 1 year. In 2010, the number of strikes more than doubled to 118. In an era of budget cuts, unmanned aerial vehicles cost just a few thousand dollars to build versus the hundreds of thousands of dollars needed to recruit and train each additional service member. So even though drones are unpopular in the countries where they're deployed, the U.S. military relies on UAVs and is looking for even more ways to use them. Rosalind Jordan, Al Jazeera, Washington.